Good morning children, I hope everyone are fine. In last class we solved the exercise number 1.2 and we completed that one. Okay, I hope everyone understood all the problems and you have remembered all the properties, multiplication properties as well as the addition properties. Okay, so today we'll see the how to represent the rational number on the number line. Okay, representation of representation of rational number on the number line. How to represent the rational numbers on the number line? Okay, so how to represent the representation of a rational number on the number line. How to represent these rational numbers? Again, you studied this one in the 7th class only. Even I taught that. I have remembered how to represent the rational number on the number line. I hope you also remember all those things in the whatever you studied in the 7th standard. Okay. So, you studied how to represent on the number line, right? How to represent the rational numbers on the number line. You studied in a 7th standard only. Can I leave these things? You only do. Okay? No. You will not do. I know that. Okay? Because you people are very lazy, right? I know. But don't be lazy this time. Please be serious about your studies. And do all the problems and do study here, everything, whatever the teachers are saying here. So please be concentrate about that and do study properly in your home. Okay, not only playing is a life. Okay, playing is not a life. You only prefer for the playing a games, right? So playing a game is not a life. Okay, so you have to study here. If you want to become a some good successful man in the future, then you have to study. Otherwise, leave. It's your wish. Okay. So, next we'll study the first natural numbers. You know how to write the natural numbers on that number line. You know that. Okay. Even you know the how to represent the whole numbers. I hope everyone know what are the natural numbers and what are the whole numbers and what are the integers and what are the rational numbers and what are the irrational numbers and complex numbers. Everything you know. Okay. So in natural number it starts with the 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. Whole numbers start with the 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Next what? Integers. Integers start with the plus or minus. It includes the plus or negative values also. Only that much. Okay. So after that, rational number. Rational number is nothing but the numbers which are in the form of a P by Q. That numbers are called as the rational number. So that rational number, see here 1 by 2 is there. It is a example for the one rational number here. So rational number, how to represent this on the number line here? That is the question here. 0 is there, 1, 2 and 3. Here 4, 5, 6, sorry, minus 1, minus 2 and here minus 3. Okay, so this is a number line. In the middle number is 0, 1, 2, 3. After the right side of the 0, every value is positive and the left side of the 0 is everything is a negative values. We know that number line, right? So how to represent this 1 by 2 on this number line? How to represent here? So first divide this number. 1, convert in a decimal numbers. That is a, we'll take a point here. So 2, 5 is a 10. What is the answer? 1 by 2 is equal to what here? 0.5. Whether 0.5 lies between a which numbers? 0.5 lies between a 0 to 1 number. Right? 0 to 1 number. So in the middle here, it is a 1 by 2 value. So this is the representation of a rational number on the number line. Getting everyone? So this is the representation of a 1 by 2 on the number line. And they again told here one more thing is there. Represent minus 1 by 7 and minus 9 by 7 on the number line. So we'll do now that one. That is, first you have to find the number where it lies. I told right, so 1 by 2 you have to do the division and you have to see the number is lying in a which two numbers you have to first recognize on the number line. Then only we can do the representation of that rational number on the number line. Otherwise, it's a very difficult to represent the number. Okay. So we'll do another problem now. That is a represent 1 by 5 and 5 by 6 on the number line. Okay. So we have to represent this 1 by 6 as well as the 5 by 6. 1 by 5 is also a rational number and 5 by 6 is also a rational number. Now we have to represent this 1 by 5 and 5 by 6. How to represent the numbers here? I told first conclude that the numbers are, this number is lying in a which two numbers, you have to conclude that first. So for that I am doing a division. I am putting a point and taking 0 here. That is a 5 to a 10. So what is the value? 1 by 5 is nothing but a 0.2. 0.2 is nothing but a, it is in lies in between the 0 and 1. In between 0 and 1, the 0.2 is present, right? So take a number line here. So starting with the 0 I am taking here. Okay. Next take here. That is a 1. Okay. So 0 and 1 I am taking. Because it lies between right here. Lines 0.2 is lies between 0 and 1. So take only two numbers here. 0 and 1. Okay. And in the denominator, which value is there? 5 is there. So we have to make a 5 equal parts. Whatever the number in the denominator, that you have to make the parts. That number of parts you have to make here. So here 5 is the, so I am making a 5 equal parts on the number line. Okay. So because of this 5, I am making a 5 parts. If there is a 2, then only make a 2 parts. If there is a 6, then make a 6 parts. If there is a 7, so 7 equal parts you have to make here. Okay. So here in the denominator, 5 value is there. So I am making here a 5 parts. That is the first, second, third, fourth and fifth one. Okay. So 1, 2. So this is nothing but here 1 only. Okay. Consider this 1 also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. First one you don't consider. After that, in last value, you have to consider the number. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is, this is a 1 by 5, 2 by 5, 3 by 5, here 4 by 5. This is a 5 by 5. 5 by 5 is nothing but a what here? That is equal to 1. 5 ones are 5 ones are. So answer is 1 only. Okay. So here we have to make the 5 equal parts. And we have to consider last value also. Don't consider the, don't count the first one. First one number, don't count. Okay. So start with the second one. That is the first, second, third, fourth, fifth. At the end is the, you have to count here. So 1 by 5. In the denominator 5 is there. So that's why I am making a 5 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is 5 by 5 is equal to a 1 only. So they told here 0.2 is nothing but a 1 by 5. So 1 by 5 is here, right? So represent like this. So this is our number what we want here. This number they told to represent on the number line. So this we already represented here. So this is the way we have to represent the rational number on the number line. It's a very easy concept. Don't think as it's a difficult. Okay. So it is a easy. First you have to do the division and you have to conclude that in which two numbers that number is lying here. So first 0.2 is lies between a 0 and 2. So I am taking only 0 and 1 value. Okay. And in the denominator 5 is this. So I am making a 5 equal parts. 5 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 1 by 5 they given here. So this is our answer. This is a representation of a rational number on the number line. Okay. So first one over here. Next one, 5 by 6. We'll do for the 5 by 6. This 5 by 6. Okay? 5 by 6. Do the division. Taking a point here, 0. Next, sub 6. 8s are 48. Okay? This reminder, don't mind. What is the answer only? We want here 0.8. 0.8 lies between which values? 0.8 lies between which values here? Whether that is a 5 by 6 or 6 by 5. Okay, sorry. 5 by 6, right? Yeah, I did correct. 6. Yes, it's okay. So here 5 by 6 I'm given here. Again 5 by 6 is a 0.8. It is lies between a which balance? Lies between the 0 and 1. We know that. Okay. So again take the number line here. That is here 0 and here is a 1. Okay. So in the denominator 5 by 6 is equal to 0.8. Okay. In the denominator, which number is there? That is a 6 number is there. So we have to make here a 6 equal parts. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4. You have to make a equal parts. Okay. So here I am taking a 1. 2, 3, no, this is also lengthy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and this one you have to consider 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Last one also you have to consider that value. That is, we start with the 1 by 6, 2 by 6, 3 by 6, 4 by 6. 5 by 6, here 6 by 6 is equal to 1 and we want on the answer as a 5 by 6. This is the representation of a given rational number on the number line. Just we have to divide the number and we have to take in which number it is lies, and that two numbers you have to take the number line, and in the denominator which number is there, that we have to make a equal parts here. 6 is there, so 6 equal parts. Next after that give a number 1 by 6, 2 by 6, 3 by 6, 4 by 6, 5 by 6, 6 by 6. So what we want here? 5 by 6. So this is here 5 by 6 is there. So this is the representation of a rational number on the number line. Getting everyone? I hope everyone understood these concepts. Okay, it's a very easy. Don't feel as it's a difficulty. Okay, so next we'll move to the how to find a rational number in between a two rational numbers. Next thing is,
so after that, yes, rational numbers between the rational numbers.
Rational numbers between a two given rational number. Okay, that is, we'll give a example one. First one is find example this one. Okay, find a rational number. Find a five rational number. Find a five rational number. Between the minus 5 by 6 and 7 by 8. They given a 2 rational number. You have to find 5 rational number which are between the minus 5 by 6 to 7 by 8. In the between the 5 by 6 to 7 by 8, there will be a many rational number are present. So you have to write the any 5 rational number between the 5 by 6 and 7 by 8. How to do this one? I hope this one came in a last class only. In 7th class you studied, right, this one? I didn't remember properly, but I hope 90% you studied this one. So how to do this one? Firstly, how to make the equal fractions. Okay? So that is a CVR. Minus 5 by 6 is there and here 7 by 8 is there. Okay. So multiply to get a same numerator. Sorry, same denominator. Denominator you have to make a equal here. Then only we can write the rational number. Otherwise we can't write in between rational numbers. Okay. So for that I am multiplying with here a which value? Here multiply with the 8 value. Okay. So multiply by 8 by 8, here 6 by 6. 8 6 are here 48, here also 8 6 are 48. Okay. Next 8 5 is a minus 40, here 7 6 is a 40. Right? Minus 40 by 48, 42 by 48. And how many rational number you will get here? Minus 40 by 48. Next. Minus 39 by 40 and minus 38 by 40. Okay. Minus 37 by 40 and minus 36 by 48. This one is the 48. They told only 5, right? So 5 we return. Even you can add a 41 by 48, 40 by 48, 39 by 48, next 38 by 48. Okay, you can add all the things because minus 42, 42, whatever the values comes in the minus 42, minus 42, 42 number. So many numbers are there, right? Minus 40 here, middle value is 0. 0 to 42 and here 0 to minus 40. Whatever the values you take here, all are the 5 rational number between the minus 5 by 6 and 7 by 8. Right? So many values are there. 40 plus 40 means some average, I think, I hope there will be a 80. Some 80, more than 80 rational numbers are lies here, right? So minus 40 to 42. Here 0 to 42 and here 0 to minus 40. How many numbers are there? So many numbers are there, right? So write any numbers. Take the numerator value, any number. 0 to 42 or 0 to minus 40, any number you can take here and write the rational number. They are asked only 5. Write any 5. Don't write all the things here. Okay, whatever the numbers you are getting, that are, you have to write here. That is a 5 rational number you have to write. So, while writing the rational numbers in between the given 2 rational numbers, we have to multiply here because we have to make a denominator. We want the in the denominator value is same here, 48, 48. We want the same value. Otherwise, we can't write the rational numbers in between those two given rational number. Okay? So that's why I am multiplying here a 8 because 8 6 is 48. Here 8 6 is 48. So here I am multiplying with the 6 value and here I am multiplying with the 8 value. Okay? So 5 is minus 40. Here 6 7 is 42. So the our number is lies between us here minus 42 48 divided by and 42 divided by 48. These are the two numbers and in between these two so many rational numbers are there. So these are the rational numbers, right? So write any 5 rational number here. That is the thing here. Okay? So this is the way we have to find the rational number in between given two rational numbers. Okay? So next I'll give some more examples, you will come to know that how to do this one. Okay, second example I'll give. Minus 1 by 2 and 1 by 10. In between these two rational numbers, you have to find the 5 rational number. 5 rational number you have to find. Y rational number you have to find. Okay, so here see number line, check the number line here. 0 is there and here minus 1 is there and here 1 is there. Okay, so 1 by 10 is nothing but what here we have to make a 10 equal parts right here. 1 by 10, 2 by 10 like that. Okay, in the denominator there will be a 10 numbers are there. So we can write here the rational numbers between these two are the 2 by 10. Next, here to here means this value to this value. You can write any numbers, right? 2 by 10. Next, 3 by 10. 4 by 10. 5 by 10. 6 by 10. 7 by 10. 8 by 10. 9 by 10 and here you are writing a minus 2 by 10, minus 3 by 10, minus 4 by 10, next minus 5 by 10, minus 6 by 10, minus 7 by 10, minus 8 by 10, minus 9 by 10, minus 10 by 10 is nothing but a minus 1. Okay, so these are the they told here to write the minus 1 by 10 and here 1 by 10 is there. But these are the not a rational number lies in between the minus 1 by 10 and 1 by 10, right? So whether these rational numbers are in between these two, here these are here only. Here these all the rational numbers are here and here. Whether these are in between these two? No, these are not in between these two. So we have to, for that sake, we have to multiply the sum numbers. Okay. Even though we are having the denominator value is same, still we are multiplying. Okay. We have to multiply. Otherwise, we can't get the rational numbers in between these two. Okay. So just 1 by 10 is there. So multiply with the which value here? Take any value. So here they took as a 10. Okay, we'll multiply with the 10 by 10 only. And here 1 by 10 and multiply with the 10 by 10. That is minus 10 by 100 and here 10 by 100. Okay, so minus 10 to 10, middle is 0. Okay, take any values. Minus 10 to 10. So many numbers are there. Minus 9, minus 8, minus 7, minus 6, minus 5, minus 4, minus 2, 1, sorry, minus 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There will be so many values are there. Take any values and write here. That is 1 by 100, 2 by 100, 3 by 100, 4 by 100. And 5 by 100, 6 by 100, 7 by 100, 8/100, 9/100. And again, call the negative value of this one. Take a negative sign also, because here are negative numbers, right? Take a negative sign also. So this much of a rational numbers are lies between these two given rational number. Okay, you can write any 5. They told to write a only 5 rational number. If they told to write a 10 rational number, you can write a 10 rational number also. Okay, so what is the thing here? If you are not getting any values in between these two, then you have to multiply with some number, and after you will get some two numbers, right? So in this between two numbers, we'll get the rational number here. Okay, so minus 1 by 10 and minus 10, 1 by 10 is there. The middle number is only 0 is there. We can't get a 5 rational number in that. Okay, so that's why I'm multiplying with the 10 by 10 and 10 by 10. Here, minus 10 by 100. Here, 10 by 100. So minus 10 by 100. Here, minus 10 by 100. Assume this is a minus 10 by 100 and this one is a 10 by 100. And the middle value is 0 here. So minus 10 to 10, there will be a many 0, many numbers are there. So we can write that rational numbers are the rational number in between these two rational number. Getting everyone? Why I have to multiply here? Because in these two numbers, we can't getting a rational number between the minus 1 by 10 as well as the 1 by 10. So that's why I am taking the 10 by 10 with the multiply minus 1 by 10 here, 1 by 10. That will get a minus 10 by 100 here, 10 by 100. Again take the number line here, 0, minus 10 by 100 and 10 by 100. In between these two, we are have a so many rational numbers. See here, minus 10 to 10, there will be so many numbers are there, right? On the number line, if you are thorough with the number line, then you can assume that here some numbers are there. Otherwise, you can't get how many numbers are here present. Okay, if we know the number line, then only you will come to know that how many numbers are lying here. Otherwise, you can't get anything here. Okay, so here by seeing only minus 1 and 1, we can say in between minus 1 and 1, only number is 0 is there. Nothing number is present in on the number line, right? So, but in between minus 10 to 10, there will be so many numbers are there on that number line. We know that. If you know the number line, you can judge this one. Otherwise, you will not. Okay, so please be thorough with the number line here. So, here minus 10 and 10 is there. In between minus 10 and 10, there will be so many numbers are there. Take that numbers in the numerator and just write the rational number in between these two rational numbers. Okay, so these are the answer. Write any 5 only. Okay, they say to write only 5. That's why we have to write only 5 rational number. So these are the two given rational number. We found that so many rational number in between these two rational number. Okay, so this is the way we have to do. I'll give some examples to do the problems. That is the homework for you. Do that one. Okay. First homework here, represent rational number on number line. Okay, first question, that is first one is minus 5 by 6, 7 by 8, 2 by 4, not 2 by 4. 3 by 4, 4 1, 10 by, not 10 here, 9 by 7, 6 1, 2 by 9. Okay, this one. Second main is find rational number between given two rational numbers. Okay, so first one is minus 1 by 7 and 2 by 7. Write a rational number. Five rational numbers here. Five rational number you have to write. Okay. 3 by 8 and 4 by 7. 1 by 6 and 7 by 3. 4 by 1. -2 by 4 and 1 by 8. 6 by 1. -5 by 7 and 3 by 9. So these are the examples you have to do. That is a homework for you people. This is a homework. Okay. So we'll meet in the next class and we'll solve the exercise number 1.3 in the next class. Thank you, everyone.